Hi, thanks for clicking in. First signs of looting and a desperate scramble for food occur in Ayutthaya, our old capital that has been overrun by floods for weeks, leaving unreachable people in starvation. Thaira's main headline exposes the harsh and embarrassing reality that Thais, who are known as people with big heart and large smiles, now have succumbed to the flood disaster and lost their soul. Matichan runs a full-page article, "Don't Lose Your Soul to the Disaster, A Lesson from the Floods," by former House Speaker and former Agriculture Minister Somsak Prisananantakun, who urged Thais to put a stop to their raw nature. He cited how the Japanese, with dignity, discipline and sacrifice, overcame three horrifying disasters, from earthquakes to a tsunami that went on to bring a nuclear crisis. Yes, we still remember how the images of orderly lines of the Japanese waiting for hours to get relief supplies went on to CNN, which reported that there was no single looting incident in Japan. Japan emerged as the noble nation from that time on. Somsak wrote, "We must learn from the floods if we want our children to grow up the same way as the Japanese children. Discipline and kind spirits must be instilled from young." The former House Speaker also came out in defense of the Irrigation Department, which has been blamed by the government for giving underestimated amount of flood waters. Somsak wrote, "In areas where irrigation officials effectively prevent floods, the officials and people in such districts were accused of being selfish because they are dry at the expense of their neighbors reeling in floods." Yes, we have seen a few sporadic conflicts between sections of people over opening and closing of border gates. Well, during a desperate attempt to save Ayutthaya, we saw politicians and officials arguing about which areas must be given priority to be protected from floods. One senior official concluded that the priority is to protect the economic zones where industrial estates are. This has, of course, left the poor farmers in the lurch again. Here comes the knight on a white horse, Thaksin Shinawat, according to Thairat's political team. The ex-PM gave an interview to the Bangkok Post saying to solve border problems, be it floods or drought, Thailand must come up with an integrated plan which will need 400 billion baht to solve the problem once and for all. 400 billion baht? Well, Thairat says Thaksin's idea is not about plunging the country into a death valley of debts, because Thailand is going to sell agricultural produce to China under a G2G agreement. Thairat's political team sums up that Thaksin is a real professional that the country is in dire need of. Well, we don't know if the reporters jumped to the conclusion too soon, because Thaksin has yet to reveal details of his pricey water management plan. Talking about water management, Komchat Duk runs an article by prominent architect Dr. Sumet Chumsaina Ayutthaya entitled, "We Must Learn to Live with Water." Sumet presents two different philosophies by two different cultures in dealing with the force of nature. One is East and the other is West. He said Dutch people for 700 years have been solving flood problems by building water gates, water pumping stations, building dams, dikes and embankments. Sumet called these approaches as fighting against nature. But people in Southeast Asia have special instinct or local wisdom, because they have been living on the banks of rivers without much suffering from floods. True, isn't it? Thai ancestors did not associate floods as unhappiness as the present-day Thais do. a rare video featuring a flood that hit Bangkok in 1942, almost 70 years ago, is a testament of the statement. The video shows tides dealt with floods with a sense of fun-loving. A lively and fun, not sad song is used as the background music. The Eastern philosophy is not to fight, but to live in harmony with nature. Well, our ancestors lived in a high pillar house or on a loft and used boats to get around. Once our leaders declared Thailand must be a rich industrialized country, we have to forego agricultural way of life. So now we are fighting a losing battle against nature because we have chosen to follow in the footsteps of the West. But meanwhile, the West realized that their way of solving floods by fighting against nature is not only expensive, but a losing battle. So Dutch people have recently adopted the Eastern approach, building amphibious communities, making floating condominiums that sails like hot cake. So this is a rude awakening for Eastern people like Thais. Ignore your roots at your own peril. Before we go, pictures of Ying Luck and Apisit working together to solve floods appear on page 1 of every paper. See how each paper reflects on this rare and special moment that brought smiles to many Thais.